Are you trying to tell me that that's the same way that the bed downstairs, the hide a bed, got broke?
What?
The hide a bed in the basement when you and the guys were watching WWE. You know, Logan.
I don't know how that broke. No.
You don't know how that broke? You were there.
This was 20 years ago. I don't remember any of this.
Yeah. It was jumping up and down. It was the hide a bed. It was the couch.
I don't remember.
It was a steel frame couch.
I don't remember any of this. I think my childhood was pretty normal for the most part. I grew up in a really small town in Buffalo, Iowa. There's no stoplights. Everyone gets their mail at a post office. Typical small town in the Midwest, you know, maybe 1,000 people.
1, 2, 3, ding ding.
I'm Holly. I'm WWE superstar Seth Rollins' mother. Talking about Seth Rollins as a child, oh my gosh. An animated individual, I used to call him the drama king. He was always the one to push the envelope. So we used to have a pool in our backyard. He would leave his shorts out there by the pool. He would dry off with the towel and then walk into the house, subsequently naked. We live at the bottom of a hill. People can see you.
Hey, we had a big fence. It made sense to me anyway.
I kind of learned from that whole issue with him that everything is very logical. When he got his first speeding ticket, what in the world were you doing? Were you not thinking about this? And he said, of course I was. He said, but there's nobody around, so what did it matter? He was totally fearless of anything. Just due to the fact that he wasn't afraid of anything, we had to set limits for him because he didn't have limits. Nothing ever was physically impossible to him. I think that's probably one of the biggest things that we found out about him when he was younger. He didn't have those limitations.
I mean, I was definitely afraid, but I still did it. I had a brother who was 3 years older than me. He was more inclined to do crazier things than I would, but I had to do it with him because I had to keep up. We'd ride bikes and build ramps and, you know, try to find the steepest hills to go down. And I never felt fearless, but maybe I suppose from a parenting perspective, it might have seemed that we were risk takers, if you will.
We had a lot of the same interests. A lot of the things that I liked, if he didn't like them, eventually I could push him to like them. So what really made us bond, I think, after a while, was wrestling.
I loved WWE since as long as I can remember. One of my favorite things was the wrestling buddies. I had a Hulk Hogan one, and my brother had an Ultimate Warrior one.
Ultimate Warrior!
I remember the specific moment when he told our parents that he wanted to be a wrestler. He was going to do this basketball training camp. And he said, I want to go to this camp, but I don't want to play basketball after that. And they're like, why? And he's like, well, I want to be a wrestler.
Devastated. I was devastated that that's what he wanted to do with his life. All I knew was that there was Mad Dog Vachon. There was the Crusher.
I think my folks kind of just thought it was something I was going to grow out of at a certain point. So, but you know, when you're 13, 14, you're very stubborn. Very hard-nosed, and I set my mind to it, and that's what I was going to do.
He was dealing with a lot of teenage angst.
You know, you're just trying to figure yourself out when you're 14, 15, 16. So, moms don't understand kids. They don't get it. You know, they never will. If I ever have kids, I'm not going to understand mine when they're teenagers.
As parents, we decided that we were going to give him the door, and we were going to open it for him. So we just took it step by step.
You know, I got out of high school, and I tried to move to Pennsylvania to train, and they were supportive and gave me some cash for that, and were really cool about it, and that didn't work out. And then when I came back from Philly, you know, they still gave me a place to live.
He was focused all the time. At one point, he was actually working part-time, going to college part-time, and he was training three times a week, which meant he drove back and forth from Chicago.
You know, it was a lot going on, but they were there to provide, you know, put a roof over my head and cook me dinner and be there when I needed them and stuff like that. And for, you know, a lot of independent professional wrestlers, that's not something they have. They're kind of off on their own doing their own thing. So I always felt like that was an advantage I have, just being able to financially be assisted by my folks, but also just have the actual support of them. Them seeing the progress that I started to make kept them more inclined to be supportive during that period of time. When I got offered the contract to go down to Florida and work for WWE in Tampa, that was the first time I really ever lived away from home. I was 24 years old. That was a massive adjustment for me. Just, you know, trying to figure out how to be an adult, you know, how to buy your own groceries and like do your own laundry, because I never did that stuff before.
There were a lot of times where I would text with him and say, how's everything going? Is it everything that you thought it would be? And every time his answer has always been, yes. He never had a plan B. This was it.
It will be a night forever etched in history. A night heroes are created, careers are defined, and legends will be born. Welcome to WrestleMania!
Yeah, WrestleMania 31.
I told them to come to WrestleMania in San Francisco basically on a whim. You know, they don't really get to see a lot of my live shows anymore, but you know, WrestleMania is like, it's the biggest show of the year, so it's just a special time. In retrospect, it was great that they were there.
We were sitting in the stands, and I remember saying to my husband, have you heard from him in a while?
I didn't have the conversation about cashing in, and I certainly wasn't going to tell anybody about it.
And it was just like within a split second. I'm like, it's going to happen, it's going to happen.
Can't imagine, really, from a perspective of a family member or a friend, kind of what that was like. That's got to be pretty surreal, as it was for me.
Having him be able to live his dream, this is it. I mean, from the time he was 5 years old.
Something that I wanted so bad my whole life. I never wanted anything else.
And my first response to him when I saw him was just to hug him. That in itself was enough.
Wrestling school, Black and Brave Wrestling School that I run. When I'm on the road, it's very difficult for me to get back and be there and be fully involved.
And my mom, she does an awesome job as far as, you know, helping me out with my wrestling school. 6 months ago or so, maybe a little less, I kind of decided I wanted to have a place for the kids to live. So I bought a place and put some bunk beds in it. It's basically a frat house.
Clean, baby.
Cleaned up, Ed.
It's always clean.
Uh-huh.
Always clean.
It's not what mom says.
I want your mom
to. It's like 13 or 14 dudes just living in there for a few months at a time and then, you know, transitioning out while a new crew comes in. And that's not something I want to deal with.
Hey! Hello! This is what I do.
You just come in and yell?
I come in and, hey!
She basically manages the entire property. When we bought it, it wasn't the nicest place in the world. And she went in and made sure it was all fixed up and got all the beds and got everything sorted and, you know, make sure we had proper, the water heater, washer and dryer, or anything you could think of that a mom would think of that I wouldn't think of, you know.
Do we have two refrigerators?
Two refrigerators, yeah.
When did I buy a second refrigerator?
I'm gonna shash your mom.
Was there just too many dudes that have one refrigerator? Is that what was going on?
I didn't even know he had two fridges.
His concept in all of this was to be able to provide these people with a place for them to live and to breathe and to join the wrestling community and have it there for them with as much ease as possible. I can help them establish themselves as far as having a place to live, having a roof over their head, getting jobs, making sure that they're taken care of.
That's just kind of the person she is. She's always been. She's just always been a caretaker.
I want them to be able to live their lives and understand that this is how it is when you're on the road. You got to commune with people, you got to figure out how to get along with people, and there's some people that you're not going to like, there's some people that you're not going to get along with, but that's life. And if you can do that and do it on a continual basis for 12 weeks, then you're probably in a good mindset. Probably just a continuation of this life with Seth Rollins and in this same vein with this school and with this house.
I want to reiterate a point that I made. You get out of it what you put into it.
He has probably made me extremely proud of the type of person that he is and how he treats other people.
I started the school kind of as a way to give back, I guess, to the independent wrestling community in the Midwest. I just really wanted to be able to have a place where someone who was me when I was that age could come here and break in and cut their teeth in the business.
I lived here my whole life, and it's one of those areas where everyone always talks about wanting to move away. Like, I never thought that way. Like, I always loved it here.
He has not become jaded. And I think a lot of that also has to do with the fact that he constantly comes back here. This is the home base. This is where the people are who are honest with him and say, hey, you know, I'm the first one, he'll tell you that. I'm the first one to tell him you messed up. And he doesn't always listen to me. You know what? I don't always listen to him either.
For me, it's really nice to come back home, have friends and family, but also just have a place that's not so chaotic. It makes it a lot easier for me to live a simpler life, I guess, instead of living in that chaos of like a New York City or Los Angeles or something like that. I couldn't do it. The traffic alone would drive me insane.
Even people that he's come back to in our community, our little town in Buffalo, have said to me, you know, you did something right as a parent because he's a decent human being. And that for me is more important than anything.